Hello everyone, this is the third video in the series of normalization in database management system. So till now we have solved all the questions of antinet from 2019 to 2012. Okay, so we have solved questions of antinet from 2019 to 2012, all the questions on normalizations. Okay, any question asked in these years in normalization, we have solved all those questions. So now we are ready to solve the questions of GATE and ISRO previous year questions on normalization. So in this video, we will solve all the questions of GATE computer science and ISRO computer science, which are being asked on topic normalization in database management systems. Okay, so let us see first question. So first question is from GATE 2016, and this question is saying, which of the following is not a super key in relational schema with attributes v, w, x, y, z and primary key is v, y? So if v, y is primary key, then that means we can add any attribute with v, y and that will always be a super key. Okay, so primary key or candidate key is the minimal super key. One of the candidate key is chosen as the primary key. So these two should always be there, and we can add any attribute with these, that will always be a super key. So v, y, w will also be a super key. Vy x will also be a super key. Okay, vy will always, vy z will also be a super key. Okay, vy w x y z, yes. So these will be a super key of two attributes, and with four attributes we will have vy w x and vy w z and vy x z. So these will be the keys with four attributes. Okay, with five attributes we will have a key vw x, y, z. So normally we say that if let us say in candidate key we have n attributes. Okay, let us say in candidate key we have n attributes, then there will be 2 to the power n minus 1 super keys. Okay, there will be this much of super keys. So here you can see, sorry, this is not true actually. So let us say in candidate key we have m attributes. Okay, if we have m attributes in candidate key, then we will have 2 to the power n minus m super keys. Okay, 2 to the power n minus m minus 1 super keys. These will be the super keys in a relation where m attributes are there in the candidate key and total number of attributes are n. So here you can see there are 5 attributes total. So the value of n is equals to 5 and the value of m is 2, because in candidate key we have 2 attributes. So total number of super keys will be 2 to the power 5 minus 2, that means 8 super keys if we include candidate key also. Okay, 5 minus 2 is 3. So those 8 super keys will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, these. Okay, so let us look at that options. So in any option in which we have vy, that is always okay. So in which we have vy, that is okay, but this is not the right answer, because in this we do not have y, so this is not a super key. So next question is, our database research article is this is a table. Let us write this table in some easy way. So volume is V, number is N, S, start page is S, end page is E, title is T, year is Y, and price is P. Okay, then we are saying that key of this relation is VN S E. Okay, this is the key of this relation, it is given, and the following functional dependencies exist. These are the functional dependencies. Okay, and the functional dependencies are VN implies T, vn implies t. Okay, vn determines t, sorry, vn se. So this one is vn se implies t. Second one is vn implies y. Third one is vn se implies p. Okay, these are the functional dependencies. Now it is saying the database is redesigned like this. So we have divided this particular relation into two parts. Okay, relation R1 and relation R2. Now it is saying which is the weakest normal form. Okay, this is very important. Which is the weakest normal form that the new database satisfies? New database satisfies, but the old one does not. This is a tricky question. Okay, so first what you need to do is, first you need to see in which normal form this new or old database is. So if we check for BCNF, BCNF says the left hand side should be a super key. We can see here left hand side is a super key, left hand side is super key, but this functional dependency is violating the definition of BCNF. So this relation is not in BCNF. Let us check for 3NF. 3NF says the relation left hand side should be a super key or right hand side should be a prime attribute. So this is not satisfying the definition of 3NF because left hand side is not a super key and right hand side is not a candidate key. Sorry, right hand side is not a prime attribute. Let us check for 2NF. 2NF says left hand side should not be a proper subset of candidate key. So here you can see VN is the proper subset of key, right? So this is a partial dependency. That means the relation is not in 2NF. So the original relation is in only 1NF. Okay, the original relation is in 1NF. Now we redesigned the relation like this. That means for this we will have functional dependencies like this. You can see VN SE implies T. This will be the first functional dependency, and VN SE implies P. These two functional dependencies will be hold for this relation R1. Okay, this one. And for this relation R2, in which we have volume, number, year, the functional dependency for this will be VN implies Y. Okay, volume, number implies year. This functional dependency will hold here in this relation. Now check first relation and second relation. The first relation is definitely in BCNF. You can see left hand side is a super key. So this first relation is in BCNF. Now check another relation. This is VN implies E. Okay, so you can see VN is the super key of this R2 relation. Yes. With VN we can get VNY. So VN is the super key of this relation R2. That means this is also in BCNF. So the new relation is in BCNF. The highest normal form of new relation is BCNF. The highest normal form of old relation is 1NF. Okay, now you need to look at this. What is the weakest normal form that the new database satisfies but the old one does not? Okay, so for example, this satisfies BCNF, but this does not specify BCNF. But this is the strongest normal form. Okay, listen to me carefully. This is the BCNF is the strongest normal form which new database satisfies but old database does not. So we need to find the weakest normal form that the new database satisfied but the old one does not. If this new database satisfies BCNF, that means this new database satisfies 3NF also and 2NF also. So the weakest normal form which this relation is satisfies, that is 2NF, but this does not. From the 2NF we cannot go more weaker. If we go more weaker, that means 1NF. After 2NF we have 1NF, but this old database satisfies 1NF and this one also satisfies 1NF. So we have to find out, but the old one does not. So old one does not satisfy 2NF, but new one satisfies BCNF, right? So the right answer is 2NF. 2NF is the weakest normal form which this old database does not satisfy but the new database satisfies. There is always, we have to find out the true and false with the reason. Okay, so there is always a decomposition into Boy Scout normal form, that is lossless and dependency preserving. This is actually false. Okay, always remember in BCNF and 3NF there is a difference, decomposition. In BCNF and 3NF, if we say about the lossless and dependency preserving, then BCNF will always give lossless dependency, lossless join. Okay, and 3NF will also give a lossless join. If we divide a relation into BCNF and 3NF, we will always have lossless join. But in BCNF, we will not always get dependency preserving. But 3NF will always give you lossless and dependency preserving. So in BCNF, it is possible that we may not get dependency preserving. Next question is, consider the relational schema ABC. Which of the in which we have functional dependencies, these we have to find out, show that the schema R is in 3NF but not in BCNF. So functional dependencies are AB implies C and C implies A. The key of this relation is, okay, the key of this relation is AB, and because A is in the right hand side of C, that means BC is also a key. Okay, so these are the two keys of this relation. Now check for BCNF. This satisfies BCNF because in left hand side we have super key, but this does not satisfy BCNF. So the relation is not in BCNF. Let us check for 3NF. 3NF says either left hand side should be a super key, this is okay, or right hand side should be a prime attribute. So we have prime attribute in this. So these two functional dependencies satisfy 3NF but not BCNF. Okay, so that we have shown. Determine the minimal keys of relation R. So minimal keys of this relation are A, B and V, C. So next question that we have already solved, the relation is in first normal form but not in second normal form. Next question is, we have functional dependencies, which one of the following is a key of R? So we have to find out the key of this relation. C tends to F, F E tends to A, E C tends to D and A tends to B. Okay, so let us see what we can have. So if we start with E, we will have EA. So let us see with EC. Okay, so EC will give you, E will give you E, C will give you C, A will, EC, E will give you A with this. Okay, and from C you can get F, right? And with EC you can get D. And how you can get B? You already have A, so you can get B. So A, B, C, D, E, F. You can get everything with EC. So EC is the key. So let's check, do we have another key of this relation except EC? So EC, you can see, do we have E or C in the right hand side of any functional dependency? We do not have EC in the right hand side of any functional dependency. That means EC is the key. Relation R is a relation which of the following does not have a lossless join dependency preserving BCNF decomposition. Okay, so we had the relation, original relation was RABCD. Okay, so you divided this relation in like this, relation R1 in which you have AB. Okay, so we have decomposed this relation like this, AB and BCD. Okay, A comma B, A implies B comma, B implies CD. That means these two are the functional dependencies, right? So in this we will have A tends to B functional dependency and the second decomposition is R to BCD. Okay, in this we will have functional dependency B tends to CD. So R1 intersection R2 is in this. Okay, first one is, so R1 intersection R2 is B and B is the super key of relation R2. Okay, so this is lossless and obviously this is dependency preserving because A tends to B will be preserved here and B tends to CD will be preserved in this relation. Then B is A tends to B, that means the relation is divided like this, R1 is AB in which we have a functional dependency, R1 is AB in which we have functional dependency A tends to B, and R2 is B tends to BC in which we have functional dependency B tends to C, and then we have R3 in which we have C tends to D. Okay, in which we have functional dependency C tends to D, right? So R1 intersection R2 is B and B is the super key of R2. That means we can combine these two and we will have a relation R12, that is ABC. Okay, then we have R3 relation CD. So R12 intersection R2 is C, right? And C is the super key of relation R3. So this is depend, this is lossless and this is also dependency preserving because A tends to B, B tends to C and TC tends to D is also preserved. But I am not understanding one thing, because the original functional dependencies are not given in this relation. Which of the following does not have a lossless joint dependency preserving BCNF? Okay, so maybe if one relation is lossy, then we can say that is not a lossless join. So this is A tends to BCD, there is no decomposition in this. And AB tends to C and C tends to AD. In which we have ABC, in this we have CAD. So the common attribute in these two will be AC, and AC is not candidate key of any of these relations. So answer should be C. You can try with all others option also. So C will be the right answer. You can try with the same approach as I told you. Next question is, for the relation R equals to L, M and OP, the following dependencies hold. R is decomposed into like this. So is the above decomposition is lossless joint decomposition? Let us try. R1 intersection R2 will be L, M and P and MO, that is M is the common attribute in these two relations. In this we will have a functional dependency M tends to O, and in this we will have functional dependencies distributed, that is P tends to L and L tends to MN. Okay, P tends to L and L tends to MN. So this is definitely lossless because we have a common attribute which is the key of relation R2. M is the key of relation R2. Okay, so this is lossless. Is the body composition dependency preserving? If not, list all the dependencies that are not preserved. Okay, so let us see. M tends to O is directly preserved. Okay, with the relation R2, this is preserved. And P tends to L is also preserved from here. And then L tends to MN is also preserved. What is the functional dependency that is not preserved? This is the functional dependency which is not preserved. So let us try, can we have this functional dependency by any rule, by applying any rule. So what we need to do is, we need to take the closure of NO plus from here, and we will get only NO. So that means this functional dependency is not preserved, and the dependency which is not preserved is NO tends to P. What is the highest normal form satisfied by the above decomposition? So highest normal form, let us see. So if this is not dependency preserving, definitely this decomposition is not in BCNF. Okay, because it is not in 3NF, because in 3NF we will always get that dependency preserving and lossless joint decomposition. Let us try, is it in BCNF or not? So let us try first relation. The key of the first relation is P. Okay, the key of this is P. So in this P is the left hand side, and L P is the super key of this relation, right? And P tends to L, L tends to MN. That means we can get P tends to MN. So L is also a super key of this relation, because no, L is not a super key because L P is not in right hand side of any relation, any functional dependency. So that means P is the super key of this relation, and this is not in BCNF. Okay, this is not in BCNF. Why it is not in BCNF? Because this functional dependency is violating the condition of BCNF. This is dissatisfying BCNF. Okay. If we try with 3NF will also not satisfied directly, because this decomposition is not dependency preserving. So the highest normal form by this is 2NF. Okay, because we do not have any partial dependencies in this. So the highest normal form satisfied by the above decomposition is 2NF. So now we are saying the relation R is decomposed using a set of functional dependencies F and S, is decomposed using another set of functional dependencies G. One decomposition is definitely BCNF and the other one is definitely 3NF, but it is not known which is which. To make a guaranteed identification, which one of the following tests should be used on the decomposition? Assume that the closure of F and G are available. So this is saying we have a relation R, and we have decomposed this relation into two parts. Okay, set of functional dependencies F and relation S. Okay, so this relation R is actually divided into two parts, in which we have R and S decomposed using functional dependencies F. Okay, F is set of functional dependencies, and in S we have set of functional dependencies G. Okay, now this is saying that one of these relation is definitely in BCNF and one of the relation is definitely in 3NF. So how to start? We know one thing, that if a decomposition is in 3NF, it will always be dependency preserving and lossless join. If a relation is in BCNF, it may not dependency preserving. So if we apply the dependency preserving definition, okay, so let us look at this by option elimination. If we apply the definition of dependency preservation, it is possible that the relation R is also dependency preserving and lossless. This is also dependency preserving and lossless. So this definition will not work. So we will not be able to identify which relation is in 3NF and which relation is in BCNF. So conditions are like this. This can be in 3NF and BCNF also. And this can be in 3NF and BCNF also. We do not know which one is which. So if we apply definition of lossless join, both are lossless join. Okay, BCNF decomposition is also lossless join, DNF decomposition is also lossless join. So these definitions will not work. If we apply the definition of BCNF, let us try with 3NF. If we apply the definition of 3NF in those two relations, they will satisfy definitely. Why they will satisfy? Because every relation which is in BCNF, it is also in 3NF. And when we are because this and this is already given, one relation is in 3NF. So we can say both of these relations are in 3NF. Because one relation is in BCNF and other relation is in 3NF. And the relation which is in BCNF is also in 3NF, right? So BCNF definition, 3NF definition will also not work. But we can try with BCNF definition. Because the relation which is in 3NF will not satisfy the definition of BCNF. So we will directly say that this relation is in not in BCNF but in 3NF. Then the remaining other relation is definitely in BCNF. So we can identify which relation is in BCNF and which relation is in 3NF using the definition of BCNF. Next question is, consider the following functional dependencies. The relation roll number, name, date of birth, age is in what? So this is saying we have date of birth implies age and age implies eligibility. Name implies roll number. Roll number implies name. Course number and I think course number implies course name and course number implies instructor. Okay, course number implies course name. And course number implies instructor. Roll number and course number implies grade. The relation roll number, name, date of birth and age, they are saying roll number name, date of birth and age. Okay, so we have to see the functional dependencies concerned with these attributes only. So this will we need to see, name, roll number we need to see, this one we need to see. So date of birth, age, name, roll number, right? So these are the functional dependencies which we need to check, this and this. So first we need to find out the keys. Okay, so name implies roll number, roll number implies name. That means name and date of birth, this is a key of this relation. Name and date of birth, because date of birth will give you A and name will give roll number. That means all the attributes, all the four attributes can be found out with the name and date of birth. Because name is in the right hand side of roll number, that means roll number and date of birth is also a key. So let us check for 3NF. 3NF says left hand side should be a key, which is not. Okay, here okay. In this also it is not okay. In this also it is not okay. So let us try with 3NF. 3NF says 3NF says that left hand side should be a super key or right hand side should be a prime attribute. Okay, so in this right hand side is a prime attribute, in this also right hand side is a prime attribute. Okay, this is satisfying the definition of 3NF, but this is not satisfying the definition of 3NF because left hand side is not a key or right hand side is not a prime attribute. Let us try with 2NF. 2NF says there should not be any partial dependency, but this is a partial dependency. It is also not in 2NF. So the relation is only in 1NF. The relation is student performance, in which we have name, course number, roll number and grade, has the following functional dependencies. Name, course number implies grade and name, course number implies roll number, course number is implies grade and name implies roll number, roll number implies name. Okay, the highest normal form for this relation is what? So the key of this relation is, let us say roll number and course number. with roll number and course number we can get grade. Okay, we can get roll number, we can get course number, we can get grade, we can get name. Name, course number, roll number, grade. ठीक है. So roll number and course number is a key, and then course number and name is also a key. Okay, this is also a key because roll number is in the right hand side of name. So we can take name as also a key. So these two are the keys of this relation. Okay. So we need to check for BCNF. BCNF says left hand side should be a super key. Okay, name and course number. This is okay. This is also okay, but these are not super keys. Okay, now let us check for 3NF. 3NF says left hand side should be a super key or right hand side should be a prime attribute. This is satisfying the definition. Right hand side is a prime attribute. Right hand side is a prime attribute. So this is in 3NF. Next question says which of the following statement about normal forms is false. Okay, so BCNF is stricter than the 3NF. Actually BCNF, yes, is stricter than 3NF because BCNF says only one thing, that left hand side should be a super key. But 3NF says that either left hand side should be a super key or right hand side should be a prime attribute. Definitely the definition of 3NF is looser than the BCNF. So BCNF is stricter, that why it is kept in the inner circle. Lossless dependency preserving decomposition into 3NF is always possible, that we have already studied. So this is also true. This is also true. Lossless dependency preserving decomposition into BCNF is always possible. No, not always. So this is false. Any relation with two attribute is in BCNF. This is also true. Okay, so only false statement is C option. So C is the right answer. Next question is this: what are the candidate keys? So A tends to B, B tends to B, C tends to D, and E tends to C, and D tends to A. So first let us try with any attribute which is not in the right hand side. So which attribute is not in the right hand side? E is not in right hand side. So definitely E will be, E will, so how, that is how we start taking the keys. So take any attribute out of these and find any attribute which is not in the right hand side. Okay, which is not in the right hand side of any functional dependency. Okay, for example, E is in the left hand side but not in right hand side of any key, any of any functional dependency. H is not coming in any functional dependency, that means H will always be in all the keys. Okay, H will be in all keys. Then A is in the right hand side, B is on the right hand side, C is also in the right hand side, D is also in the right hand side. So now we need to check manually. So let us take A. Okay, so let us try with A. A E H. So A E H will give you A B. Okay, E H. Yes. And then what we can get? So with E we can get C. So we have got A B C E H. So let us see how we can get D. We can get D from here. With BC we can get D. So AEH is a candidate key. Now see which of these attribute is in the right hand side of any functional dependency. For example, A is in the right hand side of D, that means D is also, DEH is also a super key. Just replace A with D. Okay, if A is in the right hand side of any functional dependency, just replace that attribute with the left hand side. So now see whether D is in the right hand side of any attribute. So you can see D is in the right hand side of BC. That means BC EH is also a candidate key. Okay, now need to check for BC. Do we have BC in the right hand side of any B or C in the right hand side of any candidate key? So you can see C is in the right hand side of E. Okay, C is in the right hand side of E. So you can replace C with E. So the candidate key will be now like this, B E H. Okay, because now C is replaced with E and E will already had. So if we have B E H which is candidate key, then this will not be a candidate key because this is minimal key. Okay, you can see this is subset of this key. So this can be redundant. This is redundant. This cannot be a candidate key. This is super key but not a candidate key. This is asking about the candidate keys. Okay, so BEH is a candidate key. Now see, do we have B in the right hand side of any functional dependency? So here you can see B is in the right hand side of A. So you can replace A with B and we will have this key. So we have three candidate keys in this relation: AEH, DEH and BEH. AEH, BEH and DEH. So D is the right answer. A table has filled these with the following functional dependencies. In terms of normalization, the table is in which normal form? So F1 implies F3, F2 implies F4, F1, F2 implies F5. So so how do we take first key? So I'm telling you a way of finding the keys. Just take those attributes first which are not in the right hand side of any functional dependency. For example, F1, F2 is not in the right hand side of any functional dependency. So I'm taking F1, F2 as key. I'm trying with F1, F2. So F1, F2 is a key because F1 will give you F1 and then F3 and then F2 we already have. And from F2 we can get F4 and with F1, F2 we can get F5. So this is the key of this relation. Let's see, do we have another key? So check with, do we have F1, F2 in the right hand side of any functional dependency? We do not have F1, F2 in the right hand side of any functional dependency. So this is the only key of this relation. Now check for BCNF. BCNF says in all the functional dependencies, left hand side should be a candidate key. But this is not true because this is not a candidate key. F1, F2 is a candidate key. So it is not in BCNF. Let us check for 3NF. 3NF says left hand side should be a super key or right hand side should be a prime attribute. So this is also false. Left hand side is not a super key and right hand side is not a prime attribute. Let us check for 2NF. 2NF says there should not be any partial dependency. Partial dependency means left hand side should not be a proper subset of candidate key. So you can see F1 is a proper subset of candidate key and right hand side should not be a non-key attribute. F3 is a non-key attribute. Okay, so this is partial dependency. This is also partial dependency. This is not a partial dependency because F1, F2 is not proper subset of F1, F2. So these two are just violating the definition of 2NF also. So it is only in 1NF. Which of the following statement is false? Any relation with two attributes is in BCNF. This is true. A relation in which every key has one attribute is in 2NF. Definitely, if in every key we have only one attribute, then there cannot be proper subset of that one attribute. So that there cannot be any partial dependency. So a prime attribute, we have already solved this question actually in the last video, and the answer is 3. This is false. C is the right answer of this question. So this question already we have solved in previous video. Let us see this question. And we have a relation R, A, B, C, D and functional dependencies are these. And we have divided this into three relations. R1 is AV in which we will have functional dependency A tends to B. Okay. And then we have R2 in which we have BC and the functional dependencies in this will be B tends to C. Then we have a relation R3 in which we have BD and the functional dependency in this will be D tends to B. Can we have B tends to D? D tends to B and B tends to C. That means D tends to C. Okay, B tends to C and C tends to D. That means B tends to D also implies here. Okay, so can we have C tends to B? So we have to see all the functional dependencies which can be composed using BC by applying any rule. So C implies D and D implies B. That means C tends to B is also implied here. Let us check for B tends to A. B tends to C, C tends to D. So we cannot have B tends to A. So these are the functional dependencies which are closer, which are in closer by applying any rule. So let us see for lossless join. So R1 intersection R2 is equals to B and B is the super key of relation R2. That means these two relations are lossless. We can combine these two. So R12 will become ABC. When we combine these two relations R1 and R2, this becomes R12. Now combine this relation with R3. Let us try with R3. So R12 intersection R3 is what? B. And do we have B? And B is the super key of the relation. this one. Okay, B is the super key of relation R3, because with B we can get BD. Okay, we have a candidate key is that attribute with which we can get all the attributes of that relation. So B is the candidate key of relation R3. That means this is lossless join. Okay, the decomposition into R1, R2, R3 is lossless join. Let us see, is it dependency preserving or not? So this functional dependency is already preserved directly from R1. This functional dependency is also already preserved with R2. Okay, and D tends to B is also preserved with R3. Now we have to check for C tends to D. Okay, these are the functional dependencies we have right now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So how do we check for membership? We have to check, do we have C tends to D can be is a member of this set or not. Okay, so what we need to do is take the closure of C from these set of functional dependencies. So C at closure will give C, and it will give you B, and then B will give you D. That means definitely if we are getting D in the closure of left hand side, that means C tends to D is a member of this set of functional dependencies. So C tends to D is also implied here. That means all the functional dependencies are preserved. So the decomposition is lossless join and dependency preserving. Option A is the right answer. Next question is, we have this relation and these are the functional dependencies. The relational schema R is in which normal form? So we need to find out the key first. AB tends to CD and D tends to P, C tends to E, P tends to C and B tends to G. Which of the attributes is not in right hand side? So AB is in the not in right hand side of any functional dependency. You can see in right hand side we do not have AB. So we will take AB as the key first. We will try with AB. So AB will give you ABCD. Okay, it will give you ABCD, and with C you can get E, right? And with B you can get G, and then with DE you have DE, you can get P, and then what is remaining? So we have ABCDEPG. ABCDEPG is already we got. Okay, so AB is the candidate key of this relation. So do we have A or B in the right hand side of any functional dependency? We do not have A or B in the right hand side of any functional dependency. If the right hand side are unique of all functional dependencies, that there will be only one key. Remember this. So check for BCNF. Definitely it is not in BCNF, because BCNF says the left hand side of all the functional dependencies should be a super key. So this is satisfying, but all of others are not satisfying. Let us see for 3NF. 3NF is also not satisfied. As you can see, right hand side is not a prime attribute and left hand side is not super key. Okay, let us check for 2NF. There should not be any partial dependency. So AB tends to CD is not a partial dependency. DE tends to P is not a partial dependency, because this is DE tends to P means DE also non-key attribute and P is also non-key attribute, right? Non-key tends to non-key is not a partial dependency. Okay, partial dependency is prime attribute implies non-key. Prime attributes means part of the candidate key. If we had any functional dependency like this, A tends to D, or let us say B tends to G, that is a partial dependency. Okay, because B is a prime attribute and A is also a prime attribute, which is proper subset of candidate key. A is proper subset of candidate key, B is proper subset of candidate key, and D and G are non-key attributes because they are not part of any key. That means non-key. Okay, so this is not a partial dependency. This is not a partial dependency. This is not a partial dependency, because these are non-key implies non-key. This is a partial dependency because B is proper subset of candidate key and G is a non-key. Okay, proper subset of candidate key means prime attribute. So this is also not in 2NF. So the relation is not in 2NF. This is the right answer. So we have 3-4 questions more. Okay, I will give you this question to solve. You solve this question and comment your answer in the video. Which of the following is true? Every relation in 3NF is also in BCNF. This is false. Actually, opposite is true. Every relation in BCNF is also in 3NF. A relation R is in 3NF if every non-prime attribute of R is non-prime attribute means non-key attribute is fully functionally dependent on every key of R. This is the definition of actually BCNF. This is the definition of PCNF, not 3NF. Okay, this is saying every non-prime key, non-prime attribute. Non-prime attribute means non-key attribute. This is saying, let us say if Y is non-prime attribute, it is fully functionally dependent on a key. Okay, let us say X is a key. Fully functionally dependent means it should be fully functional. That means that the part of X should not actually, let us say A is a subset of X. So we should not have anything like this, A tends to Y. This will become a partial dependency. Okay, if A is the part of X, for example, let us say we have A, B, C, D, in which, let us say, A, B is a key and C, D are non-key attributes. Okay, this is key. These are non-key attributes. Okay, if we have functional dependency like this, A, B tends to C, this is the meaning of this line. This line is saying this thing. This is C is non-key. That means non-prime attribute. Non-prime attribute of R is fully functionally dependent on every key of R. Fully functionally. Okay, that means this is fully functionally dependent. And this is partially functionally dependent. Okay, part of A. So this is the definition of BCNF, not 3NF. In 3NF, we can have like a non-key attribute can be like partially right. Non-key attribute. This is definition of 2NF actually. Every relation in BCNF is also in 3NF. This is true. No relation can be in both BCNF and 2NF. This is false. This is also false. So C is the right answer. Next question is saying every table with two single valued attribute is in 1NF, 2NF, 3NF and BCNF. This is true. Two single valued attribute. I told you na, every binary relation is in BCNF. Every relation with two attribute is in BCNF. And if a relation is in BCNF, then it is 3NF, 2NF and 1NF also. What is the minimal cover of the functional dependencies? This. So the questions of minimal cover I will solve in the separate video. Okay, so I will tell you what is minimal cover. Actually, I have already taught minimal cover in my database course. So I will again upload the videos on minimal cover because I'm solving the topics topic wise. So I'm making the videos topic wise. That means now I'm talking about only decomposition and normalization. I will not talk about minimal cover. That I will cover in the separate video. So these were all the questions of last like 10 to 20 years which are being asked in GATE and ISRO from topic normalization in DBMS. So in next video we will come with the next topic, a new topic in database management system. Okay, till then take care and keep studying.